Capital CMG artist Anne Wilson released her full-length debut album over the weekend. The album is My Jesus. The compilation of emotional declaration comes from the young singer's experience with tragedy and how God's tangible presence got her through. Anne Wilson was raised in Lexington, Kentucky. Wilson grew up in a Christian home, and she didn't really know the Lord until the seventh grade when a Bible teacher went to her school and explained the love of Jesus in a way that resonated with her. What she didn't know at the time was how much she'd soon be depending on her relationship with God to carry her through the next season of her life. I became a follower of him and didn't know just what would happen 3 years later. In 2019, my older brother Jacob passed away in a car accident at the age of 23, Wilson said in an interview.
It was 3:30 in the morning, and my sister came running into my room. She said, "Anne, I think something happened to Jacob." And so I look outside, and the only thing I can see are flashing blue lights. I run downstairs, and the first thing I see are six policemen standing in front of my front door. They all had really sad faces. So I walked into the living room, and I see my parents. My mom was sitting on the chair, screaming and crying. My dad was sitting on the couch with his head in his hands. And I just walked over to him, and I just said, "Dad, is he dead?" He had just died in a car accident 3 hours prior. I was in shock. I couldn't even cry at that moment. It's probably the most hopeless feeling in the entire world when you lose someone that you love.
That was such a hard season in my life. He was my best friend, and I loved him with everything in me. We were so close, and he died tragically in a car accident and died on impact, she continued.
It almost feels like you cannot take your next breath. I heard the Lord say to me so clearly, "Anne, are you going to trust me or are you not?" So I turned around and I faced the doors in that room and I said to the Lord, "Jesus, I trust you." As a family, it was very devastating to lose Jacob.
The tragedy of Jacob's death was devastating for Wilson and her family, but amid the heartache, they found comfort in Jesus. Instead of turning from him, we chose to walk closer to him through that time.
When you lose someone you love, there's a decision that has to be made. It's very easy to be angry at the Lord and to blame him. But the Lord really showed me that I needed him more than anyone, and that he's sovereign and that he's good no matter what. Yes, I have questions, and it's okay to have questions, but there was no point for me to be angry at the Lord when I needed him most,
she said. So I became on fire for the Lord and just chose to trust him. We saw the Lord do a lot of really incredible things, and he was just so faithful and kind to me and my family, and it was such a sweet season. Upon hearing of her brother's death, Wilson felt compelled, such a strong way, to sit at the piano and worship for the first time. Although she had played the piano her entire life, she had never felt compelled to worship before. Her mother heard her singing and asked Wilson to sing at her brother's funeral, which launched her music career.
The next morning, I got some time to myself, and I sat down at the piano, and I just started to sing "What a Beautiful Name." I really just took that time to thank the Lord for giving me Jacob for the years that I had him. And as I was playing and just worshiping the Lord, my parents came in, and they heard me singing it, and they asked me if I would be willing to sing it at the funeral. And at first I said no, absolutely not. I had never sang in front of anyone before. And so I sat down with the Lord and I just talked to him and prayed with him. And I really felt him calling me to sing at the funeral. And so I eventually decided that I would sing, and I got some friends together and we put together a version of "What a Beautiful Name." As I walked up on stage and I sat at the piano, The Lord took every bit of nervousness away from me. I heard him say to me so clearly that I was called to worship him.
When he passed away, I just wanted to worship God, and I found myself, instead of turning to medication or alcohol or something else, it was like I wanted to turn to the Lord for my medicine when I needed comfort or when I needed just to be comforted. I'd go straight to the piano and worship and sing, the 20-year-old explained. I ended up making a YouTube video of the song that I sang at the funeral and posted it on YouTube, Wilson added. That was what ended up going viral, and I met my manager from that video, and that's how everything started. I started working in the industry and doing co-writes and really just processing all the loss of Jacob and what I had gone through with him. And then ended up signing a record deal in 2019 and started walking down the path of being a Christian artist. Wilson described herself as being on fire for God and said others can follow suit by having their own personal relationship with God.